हेलो स्टूडेंट, वेलकम टू डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ जूलॉजी श्री मुलिका देवी महाविद्यालय निगोज तालुका पारनेर डिस्ट्रिक्ट अहमदनगर. इन प्रीवियस वीडियो लेक्चर वी वाज डिस्कस द टेक्निक्स यूज इन सिल्कवर्म रेयरिंग. इन दैट वी वाज स्टडीड सम एस्पेक्ट, फॉर एग्जांपल व्हाट इज माउंटिंग, देन टाइप्स ऑफ माउंटिंग. दिस टू पॉइंट्स इज स्टडीड इन प्रीवियस वीडियो लेक्चर. नाउ टुडे आई विल स्टार्ट द नेक्स्ट पॉइंट वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट in during the silkworm rearing, that is to study the environmental condition and care during the cocoon spinning. This point is very important during the silkworm rearing, because depending upon this point, it is depend your result or final production of silkworm or sericulture activity. So let us start to study the environmental condition and care during the cocoon spinning. In that, the first point, that is to study the environmental condition. For example, you know the silkworm is very sensitive in their environmental condition. So it is necessary to provide optimum condition during the rearing period. The environmental condition during the mounting is play very important role. Because if, for example, a very small amount of the moisture is increased or moisture will be decreased during the rearing condition, that time your silkworm larva feeling uncomfortable or they are not produce a well quality of cocoon. So it is necessary to always study the environmental condition during the rearing. The mounting and spinning are to be carried out with the most care to get the good quality of cocoon. You know, if you are not care your silkworm larva during the mounting, it is not just during the mounting, whole life cycle is very important during the rearing. So it is your duty to care your larva and to always study, to always analysis the health of the larva, because whatever your final production, that is cocoon, quality of cocoon, is depend on health of larva. So it is necessary to always care your silkworm larva. In ideal condition for the good spinning are, for example, your silkworm required 22 to 23 degree centigrade temperature and humidity required between the 60% to 70% in rearing house. This is ideal condition for well and good growth of your silkworm larva. So sericulturist always kept in your mind, it is necessary to provide these two necessary condition during the spinning or rearing of silkworm larva. These condition are important during the first 50 hours. During the mounting is start, so you are always focus the temperature of the rearing house is optimum, and this is very important for the you can get quality of cocoons. So if you are not studied the temperature and humidity of rearing house, you are affecting the final production, that is cocoon production, and quality of cocoon, then health of cocoon is always affected if you are not provide suitable or ideal condition during the rearing. I hope you are understand what is the importance of environmental condition during the spinning or rearing of silkworm or spinning of cocoon. So it is your duty to provide this condition to your silkworm and to get a good quality and quantity of cocoon. Finally, if you are gotted this type of cocoon, your income will be 100% increase or you got a good income from the sericulture. Next important point, that is care during the spinning of cocoon. Which care? Silkworm care. Care during the spinning of cocoon, because you know this is the final stage of silkworm larva or your final stage of final production. So it is necessary to always care your silkworm during the spinning the cocoon. In mounting room, that is your rearing house will be divided into mounting room. Mounting room always kept old newspaper mat are put under the mounting frame. When urine and excreta of silkworm falls on the paper, it must be removed from the rearing tray. You know, your silkworm is completed their whole life in rearing tray. So whatever excreta, whatever their excretory material, that is urine and waste material produced from the silkworm, they are fall on the particular newspaper. So it is easy to remove out or to clean your rearing tray. So it is your prior duty to kept your clean rearing house or try to keep hygienic condition in rearing house. Samajh mein aa raha aapko? If the temperature rises beyond the 22 to 23 degree, then shall become very loosey and flooded with wrinkles and knots. If the temperature of rearing house is very high, you can face this problem in your cocoon. So if you want to avoid this, you are always try to maintain this temperature in rearing house. This includes cohesion of silk filament. You know, means whatever the filaments of silk is cohesed and causes difficulty in reeling. Means your silkworm cocoon is totally disturbs and they are facing trouble during the reeling. In future, you want to just reel your silk thread from the cocoon. That time you are facing difficulty, or it is not easy to reel your silken thread from the cocoon. Low temperature show down the secretion of silk, however resulting the large size of cocoon. If your temperature is going down, that time the secretion of silk have the resulting very large size of cocoon. Means your minimum or optimum size of the cocoon is whatever the your cocoon will be required, the your silkworm is produced large size cocoon. So the farmers do not understand what is happening during this condition, and they are facing trouble. They are produce very large size cocoon. Further, it takes place very long time for the spinning. You know, if the size of the cocoon is very large, that time you are not completed your spinning procedure. So it is necessary to provide the optimum temperature during the spinning of cocoon. Next one, the humidity is between the 60 to 70%, includes good health, good reliability and quality of cocoons. These three things is very important during the sericulture, because whatever your result is depend on your humidity and temperature. Means your silkworm is well in health, so your cocoon is produce very good in quality, the size same. When it rises, means what one? Which one? Humidity. Humidity, the larva and pupa cause death. If the humidity is increased, the larva and pupa will be dead. Low humidity causes double layered cocoon. If in between this, that is 60 to 70, if your humidity is very low, that time you are facing trouble, that is double layered cocoon or loosey cocoons, loss form of the cocoons you are getting from the particular silkworm larva. I hope you are understand what is the importance during the caring of your silkworm in spinning steps or spinning procedure. Excessive moisture and harmful gases are released from the feces and urine of silkworm. You know, the silkworm are excrete out urine and excreta in the your rearing house. They are produce some harmful gases, so they are facing trouble during this condition. So it is necessary to always clean your rearing bed. Samajh mein aa raha? Air current speed should be less than 1 meter per second. This is the on an average speed of air flow, it will be 1 meter per second. And fast or strong air current causes crowding of matured silkworm, resulting in excessive number of double cocoons. Means if you want to the good quality of cocoons, you are always kept in your mind, that is the window and doors of your rearing house should be close, or you can just open a few number of the windows that can be maintain good ventilation. You are always try to avoid very fast wind flow and air current, because the mature larva will be starting crowding. This will be not good for the producing good quality of cocoon. Mounting room requires moderate light. Strong light causes crowding of silkworm and one side, and finally result in double cocoon. It is necessary to provide moderate light. If you are providing continuous very high and strong light, causes crowding of silkworm at the one side, and finally the result in the double cocoon. Means this condition is helpful to producing the double cocoon. So if you want to avoid this, you are provide moderate or required light inside the your rearing house. I hope you are understand what is the importance during the caring your silkworm. You are always kept in your mind to provide whatever the suitable condition, that is regarding airflow, regarding hygienic condition, regarding your light, regarding your food material. These all the care should be completed, should be done in your rearing house during the spinning the cocoon. Silkworm crawling on the mountage are prevented. You know, during the maturity stage, the silkworm are starting crawling on the mountage. It will be prevented or to avoid this during the spinning the cocoon, because it is not good for the you are spinning the cocoon steps. I hope you are understand first 2 points, that is environmental condition and care during the spinning and reeling the cocoon. Spinning the cocoon, sorry. First one, that is to provide newspaper and mat under the mounting frame. These are the first care, because you are easily perform the your cleaning activity, because when urine and excreta falls on the paper, you are easily removed out. Second one, temperature is always between the 22 to 23 degree inside the rearing house, because if you are not count the temperature, the temperature will be goes beyond the 22 to 23, it will be affected the quality of cocoon, that is loss of cocoon folded and wrinkles and keynotes on the cocoons. Then if the temperature go very low, that time your silkworm starting secretion of silk is resulting double size and large size cocoon. Very fast secretion will be happen during this condition, so you are not get the proper timing cocoon, because it will be increase the timing of spinning. Low temperature, then humidity between the 60 to 70%, this is the very good for the during the spinning the cocoon. If that if the humidity is high, that time the pupa and larva cause death. If the humidity is very low, that time you are facing trouble regarding you can produce the larva produce the double layer cocoon or lossy cocoons. Next one, that is next care during the spinning, that is moisture and some gases will be produced inside the rearing house. So it is necessary to always clean the your rearing tray during the spinning the cocoons. Then last point, that is very important, air current should be less than 1 meter per second, because if the very fast and strong air current flowing inside the your rearing house causes crowding of the mature silkworm larva, resulting double cocoons or large number of cocoons will be produced in double forms. Then mounting room requires the moderate light, that is your artificial light. You can provide the moderate or required light, because strong light causes the crowding of the silkworm, and at the time one side they finally result the double cocoons. Then final one, that is very important, to avoid the crawling of the silkworm on the mountage during the spinning of cocoon. I hope you are understand these two points very easy to understanding what is the environmental condition required for during the spinning of cocoon and care during the spinning of cocoon. Now next point, that is harvesting of cocoon. What is harvesting of cocoon? So after the cocoon are completely formed, they are removed from the mountage, and the surrounding false is removed is called as harvesting. Means after the completion of the final spinning of cocoon, it is necessary to remove out the cocoon from the mountage or to clean out just whatever the materials attached on the cocoon. You can just clean out, remove the falses, are called as harvesting of cocoon. The cocoon are harvested only after the ensuring that the spinning is complete. It is very important to always study the their stages or to count the time of the spinning period. So you are always harvested your cocoon at the perfect timing, or you are always study the spinning is completed. After the spinning is completed, you can start the harvesting the cocoon, and the mature larva contained inside in the cocoon, how the metamorphize into pupa on the 4th to 5th day of spinning. This is the ideal condition to start the harvesting of cocoon. The silkworm larva metamorphosis into pupa after the spinning the cocoon for the about 28 hours from the time they are mounted. Generally pupation takes place the 4th day of spinning. if you want to harvest the cocoon, you are always focus on this point. The spinning is completed after the cocoon is completely spin. That is spinning the cocoon for about 24 hours from the time they are mounted. That is beginning. They are mounted. You can start the spinning the sorry harvesting the cocoon. Now next point, that is sorting of cocoon. Among the harvested cocoon, there are normal cocoon, slightly defective cocoon, highly defective cocoon, double cocoon, and unhealthy cocoons. So it is necessary to reject the defective cocoon. You know, according to environmental condition, according to during the care and handling of the cocoon, harvesting of cocoon, you are always find out some cocoon is defective, that is slightly defective, highly defective, double cocoon, unhealthy cocoons are produced from the silkworm. So it is necessary to sort out cocoon. That is, you can just keep a normal cocoon in one container, then slightly defective cocoon in one container, highly defective cocoon is kept in another container. So you are sort out according to their stages of cocoon. It is very necessary because to reject and to avoid the problem during the marketing. So to sort out according the stages or health of the cocoons, this is known as sorting of cocoon. Sorting of cocoon is carried out mainly for the double, thin sealed, dead, dirty, low sealed, very thin, and transparent thin middle cell frame and irregular cocoons. I was already give the information regarding their stages. So according to stages, it is necessary to sort out the cocoon. All these are carefully separated and rejected only. For example, double, then unhealthy, slightly healthy, slightly defective, highly defective cocoons are rejected. Only good quality of cocoons that are normally are picked up from the future checking or future uses. Next one, that is very important. According to color, the color of cocoon is commonly reared in normally white in color. Beside this, the color, there are different in color such as golden yellow color, flesh yellow color, leaf color, and green colors. Cocoons are also produced from silkworm larva. So according to colors, you can also separate out in previous information, that is normal cocoon, then slightly defective cocoon, then highly defective cocoon, double cocoon, and unhealthy cocoon. Samajh mein aa raha? You can sort out. Then according to their health, that is dead and thin, normal thin sealed, that is thinness of silk thread, you can also separate out. Then regular, irregular shape of the cocoon. These all the stages you can check out and to sort your cocoon according to good health of the your cocoon. Last point, during the sorting of cocoon, you know generally the cocoon color is very important during the marketing. So color of cocoon is commonly reared in mostly white in colored, because this cocoon is marketed to the textile industry. So they want to produce the different types of your another byproduct, that is your textile industry produce different cloth and other materials. So they want to the pure white color cocoon. So according to color, you can also sort out. Beside this one, you know, the silkworm are also produced golden yellow, then flesh yellow, lip color, that is your green color of cocoon. So this type of the cocoon is not gotted the good quality and good price in market. So you can just sort out only white, well shape, well size and well health of cocoon to marketed in your market and to got the good income from the sericulture industry. I hope you are understand all the points of today's lecture. If you have any difficulty, any questions regarding today's lecture, you can ask me in comment box. I will give the all the answers of your question. Thank you very much for all of you.